Hey, what's up guys, welcome back, you're watching for Tech. 2 days before we reviewed the new OxygenOS 15 v850 update, which was just arrived for OnePlus 13 and 13R devices. There we discuss almost all new features one by one. You can check that video link given in Icard. As I promised in that video, I will do performance and battery test of OxygenOS 15 v850 update. So you all will get clear idea if you need to update to this OTA or not, because most of the time we've seen after upgrading to new versions, some users are facing performance or battery life issues. So today in this video, I tried to provide you my honest opinion after testing performance of this update and battery life after 2 days of uses of this device as a primary device with new update. So watch this video until the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. So first of all, I will show you the performance results of this update. I did performance testing of this update using Geekbench and Antutu benchmark testing applications and then compared these results with values of old V840 update, and here are results. On 21st August, I did the test of this new update while old test was done on 25th July. That was on old V840 build. Without performance mode, the new V850 update given me score of 2138 and 5006, while old build V840 have 2150 and 4967 for single and multi-core CPU performance respectively. Slight improvement has been noticed here for multi-core scores for new update. With performance mode on V850 update, I got score of 2126 and 5612. While for old V840 had scores of 2165 and 5682. Here slight downgrade of scores for multi-core results is happened in new update as compared to old V840. If we compare the GPU test scores without performance mode enabled, old V840 have score of 14163 while new 850 got score of 14386 for OpenGL graphics API respectively. While on the Vulkan graphics API, old V840 have score of 16205 and new V850 have 16339. So for both OpenGL and Vulkan graphics API, scores were higher in a new build as compared to old V850. With performance mode, old build got score of 14656 while new build got the score of 14706. And for Vulkan graphics API, old build have score of 16200 while new build have score of 16190. For Antutu benchmark testing, I got the score of 2020,864, while with old V840 update, I got the score of 1949,591. Here you got huge 71,000 score improvement with new update for OnePlus 13R. So both Geekbench and Antutu benchmark testing score confirms that new V850 update did slight improvement both for CPU and GPU scores as compared to old V840 update. Next, I did the multi-thread CPU throttle testing for 10 minutes where I got the results of total CPU throttling was happened only for 2%. Total temperature risen from 49 degrees Celsius to 68 degrees Celsius. CPU throttle graph remained green for maximum portion. So in terms of CPU throttle, this update also performed well, means even with heavy tasks, device will able to manage heat and less CPU throttle will happen, which will not downgrade your device performance. Now it's time to disclose battery performance of new update. Remember, battery results which I am going to show you may vary as per your device usage pattern and device battery health. Here in my case, my device battery health is 100%. This is my average user's pattern, means it's not heavy and not too much low, it's 50-50. I use a device with balance mode from 100 to 12%, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, NFC, GPS always on display, all of these things are on all the time. And here are my results. I got total 1 day and 15 hours of total standby time with 8 hours and 30 minutes of screen on time. I am using the device mainly for shooting of my YouTube videos and editing purpose. So two most battery consuming applications are camera and Icard video editor application. And also using this device for some other daily activities. So you can consider it as more than average users, and results are really very good with new update. They are almost same like old build we tested previously. You will get the old build battery review in the Icard video link. Overall, this new update have really very good performance and battery life, even though if you are a heavy user. There is no downgrade of performance and battery life has been noticed as compared to old build. So I definitely recommend you to upgrade to new V850 update if it's arrived on your device. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content related to OnePlus OxygenOS, its features and news. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.